It's only a game. Why you have to be mad?
What is up, Heroes of Dominion? My name is Charlie. This is Hero Wars Central, and in this video, I want to discuss the upcoming Hero Wars mobile event, Runic Millstone. This event is from April 28th through the 30th, and it is one of the regular in-rotation events. Hasn't really changed much in the past year or 2 years or what have you. It is, you know, one of the better events to invest in, but we'll talk about that a little bit more in just a second. On screen now, I want to show you the different tasks that you can expect to complete during this event. So if you are interested in getting the most out of this event possible, wait to do any of these tasks until the event goes live at 2 a.m. on April 28th, and you'll get an extra fourth day out of this event. I wanna thank LoadRunner for data mining the information and sharing it with us. There's also gonna be some of those, some new bundles to purchase on the side there, but I'm not gonna ask you guys to spend any money, so I'm not even gonna show what those bundles are. When it comes to the glyphs, high level discussion about them, you can search my channel, go to youtube.com/HeroWarsCentral and search for glyphs, and I've done a number of videos about it. I'll also add some glyph videos at the end of this video. But each hero has 5 glyphs. The max level of glyphs is 40, and the glyphs unlock as you promote the color rank of your hero. So for example, Kark here, I can't upgrade his physical attack glyph until I promote him to blue. His health glyph, I can't promote it until I promote him to blue. Armor penetration glyph, I need to be violet. Armor glyph, violet +1. And then finally, his fifth and final glyph, I need to be violet +2, that is agility. There are 2 ways to level up all of your runes or your glyphs. The first is to collect these runes right here and use those combined with gold to slowly level these bad boys up. You can also just straight spend emeralds to kind of speed up the process. In that way, it's kind of a pay to win stat. A lot of the things in this game are designed to be sped up using emeralds. Not everything, but this is definitely one of them. Now, when it comes to Hero Wars Mobile, the game itself, on where and how you should invest your resources, because indeed this is a resource management game above everything else. There are 2 primary schools of thought outside of the free-to-play versus pay-to-win conversation. You could focus a lot of resources on your heroes, or you could focus a lot of your resources on your titans. And you could, you know, definitely some in between there as well. I guess there, you know, black or white, 2 extremes isn't the best way to kind of define it. But if you are interested in having more fun and doing more of the activities in the game and enjoying those activities, and I'm talking like the campaign, Outland, Tower, all of that kind of stuff, then investing in your heroes is going to be the more important thing. However, if you're trying to be hyper competitive in guild wars, cross-server wars, it's going to be more beneficial to you and your guild to invest more of your resources into your titans. All right, this game actually should be called Titan Wars if we're going to be honest with ourselves. So that's not to say that a strong hero team won't be effective in Guild Wars, but in order for your heroes to be effective, you need a larger pool of heroes than you need the size of pool of Titans. So there are 12 Titans, but there are 50 plus heroes. And in order to be competitive, for example, you probably need to have 20 to 30 strong heroes, whereas on Titan Wars, you only need, you know, maybe 8 of the 12. But, you know, I'm not going to get into much more than that in this video. Again, special thanks to LoadRunner for sharing this information with us and getting this to us ahead of time. Sure would like to have some advance notice on entire month's events so we can kind of talk about those in detail and plan finances for the entire month, but this is the best we can do. I will say, if you'd like to plan the leveling of your Kark or whatever hero that you're interested in, check out HeroWarsCentral.com in the game mechanics section right here. You can kind of go down to stat leveling priority, and this is not going to work for every single hero, and this is not going to work for every single team, but if you're looking for a general advice on what stats to level first for each hero, be it a tank, a damage dealer, a healer, support control style hero, then this is generally accepted as the stats to focus on. If you're a tank, focus on your armor, magic defense, or dodge first. If you're a damage dealer, focus on that armor or magic penetration first. And if you're anything else, a healer, support, or control, then focus on that health first is going to give you the best bang for your buck. Of course, there are some exceptions. You can see I've got it right here in bold, right here in the middle. And this could extremely vary depending on the team makeup that you have. Sometimes that Celeste is going to be more of a damage dealer in your team. Sometimes that Celeste is going to be more of a healer. That's just an example. There's a lot of exceptions given a team. But if you're curious, this is kind of a nice little breakdown for it. And this goes for, you know, skins and artifacts as well as the glyphs. If you're going to invest a little bit of resources in this event, try not to do too many of the daily tasks right now. Wait until 2 a.m. UTC on April 28th. That's a little over 12 hours from now, so that you can get that fourth day out of the event. We're going to see what's going to be be the next event. Hopefully, I was really hoping for a Titan Artifact event next, but I guess not. I don't know. I don't know what they're thinking. That's really all I'm going to say about that. I love you all. Good luck in Dominion.